Sonic. Listen to the difference.
Hello, my name is Jonathan Hoskin, and I'm Business Development Manager for Amptronik's OEM team. And I'm going to give you an introduction to hearing assistance in the rail environment. So why invest in assistive listening? Of the approximate 7 billion people worldwide, approximately 360 million of those live with disabling hearing loss. This is according to figures from the World Health Organization. And that's approximately 5% of the global population. A large proportion of these will likely use some form of public transport in their lifetime. Audiologists can tailor a hearing aid to suit the user's specific requirements, and there are now many different styles and models on the market, but all hearing aids work on the same basic principle. The example shown here is a traditional behind-the-ear style. Sound is captured by a microphone located somewhere on the outside of the hearing aid and positioned outside of the ear. The omnidirectional microphone translates the sound into an electrical signal that is then processed and amplified by the hearing aid. The sound is then reproduced and delivered directly into the ear canal by the hearing aid speaker. However, this doesn't completely solve the problem. A modern hearing aid can correct frequency-dependent hearing loss to an extent. However, it cannot remove acoustic artifacts such as background noise, reverberation, or anything else that might cause a coloration of the audio. An assistive listening system is typically employed to address the issues that we mentioned in the previous slide. The most common of which is an induction loop system. An induction loop system is intended to use the hearing aid, which ensures that the sound is tailored to the user's requirements. There are no receivers necessary, although they should be kept in stock for people who perhaps want to use a system but don't have a telecoil. But most hearing aids have a telecoil built into them, and the number is approximately 80% of all hearing aids globally have a telecoil. An induction loop system is typically favoured by users because there is no need to identify themselves by asking for a receiver, and there are no perceived hygiene issues that you may foresee when sharing receivers. Facility managers typically prefer this solution because they are effectively a fit and forget type system. They require very little maintenance and management beyond annual retest and regular checks of the system to ensure that it's still operating as required. In transport applications, the intended users of the systems are passing by areas that are not staffed, so it may be impractical to dispense receivers. For this application, induction loops are the only applicable assistive listening solution because they connect directly to a hearing aid. A hearing aid user needs to simply select the telecoil setting on their hearing aid to access the service. As well as providing these systems, as we want to make life easier for people with hearing loss, there are also legal obligations. Different countries will have their own legislation that applies to providing equal access to people with disabilities, but this is largely based around the UN Convention of the Rights of People with Disabilities. This is an international agreement setting out the steps governments must take to ensure disabled people enjoy their human rights to equality without discrimination, an inclusive education, support to participate in society, and accessible physical environments and information. These laws generally don't go into specifics on the technology or methods that should be used, but set a basic underlying requirement that provision must be made to give someone with a disability the same level of access to services as anyone else. Amptronik specialises in solutions for transport, and in particular rail applications, both on board and as part of the infrastructure in stations and on platforms. We work with and support our project partners from concept through to commissioning. One example of where loop systems could be employed in infrastructure are counter applications. In this case, the loop is always on and can allow a staff member to help a hearing impaired user without need for any extra equipment or any difference to their behaviour that may erode the anonymity of the user. There is an Amplitronic loop solution for every application in the user's rail journey where there is an audio service. The station and platform infrastructure is just as important as the service on board. Amplitronic have been developing and perfecting solutions for these applications for many years. Some of these solutions will include car park systems, concourse areas, PHPs and PAIs, ticket vending machines, platforms, and lifts and elevators. Platform shelters and waiting areas around passenger information systems also need to be looped. There's typically not a lot of environmental issues to contend with in these environments, and therefore a simple loop solution such as a perimeter loop can be utilised. As shown, help points and emergency intercoms are quite ubiquitous in stations and on platforms. Ideally, the loop wire itself should be installed into the floor. However, if this isn't possible, then the loop can either be built into the housing or installed in a separate panel, as shown. Loops for onboard rail applications. Onboard a rail vehicle is typically a challenging and more regulated environment, where we must be concerned with EMC, fire and vibration standards. There is also very high metal loss on board a rail carriage, and we must compensate for the attenuation that this causes to the magnetic field by having powerful loop drivers. Now, because of these factors, system design is extremely important, and it is easy to get wrong. Therefore, a loop specialist should be employed when specifying a system on board. It is possible to loop sections of the carriage. For example, the section for wheelchairs, but this could be considered discriminatory by the users of the system, as we're not providing complete coverage of the carriage. It is also worth noting that it doesn't really save much in the way of cost, as you will still require one amplifier, and the loop wire is a comparatively negligible value. The only case where you could potentially save cost by reducing coverage is where the build of the carriage presents such a high amount of metal loss that we would need two separate loop systems to cover the whole car. This drawing shows a plan view of a train carriage and a typical layout. The drawing below it shows a sectional view of the carriage. You can see that the loop is not installed directly to the ceiling, but slightly below to reduce metal losses. These next two slides, I'm going to give you some details of two case studies. The first of which are the Matangi trains in Wellington, New Zealand. And the second one will be the Nottingham Transport trams. These trains were built by Hyundai Rotem, and they've been in service since 2010. The passenger information system was supplied by Inter-M, and it was initially a 96-car fleet, extended by an extra 70 cars. We have covered 50% of each car with assistive listening. This slide shows the loop path and the feed cable path. As mentioned before, this is installed just below the ceiling at height. Now, here is the cross-section in more detail. You can see the proposed loop wire position, and you can see where the cable is routed over the top of ducting to avoid any issues. This next case study is the Nottingham trams. These trams were built by Alstom and have been in service since 2015. This was a new build addition to an existing fleet of 22 new trams. Two sections of each tram were provided with assistive listening, with one loop driver per area. So this slide gives you an overview of the installation location and some photos of the loop installed in situ. It's important when specifying a loop system to understand the standards to which a loop should be assessed. IEC 60118 Part 4 is the international performance standard for hearing loop systems, and it defines in detail the acceptable parameters of the magnetic field generated by the loop. All of Amplitronic's designs and advice are based around meeting this standard, as we know that a system which is in line with this performance criteria will be capable of giving a significant benefit to the end user. This standard is also what systems should be commissioned to, so any certificate provided upon completion of the installation will be based around compliance to 60118 Part 4. It's important to understand that while standard compliance is the aim and may be defined in the specifications of your project, a system just outside of these figures can still be of huge benefit to a hearing aid user. And if that's the best that can be achieved due to practical constraints, then a loop system shouldn't necessarily be ruled out. Thank you. If you have any further questions, please email support@amplitronic.com, visit the website, amplitronic.com, or call this number. Thank you for listening. Bye-bye.
Listen to the difference.